Welcome to the Temple of Elemental Evil, a Dungeons & Dragons game made from, by Atari, Troika, however it's supposed to be pronounced, which was quite buggy, actually, back in the day, but I am using the Circle of Eight mod pack. That fixes quite a bit of the issues, except for some, but I know about those, that's fine. I also have the new content thing applied, so I will have extra things, stuff I'm not used to in the game, and, I will be able to reach level 20. The old limit is 10. Let's see, what else? Just so you know what's going on, I can also have increased the default party size from 5, the old version, to 6. Now, you might be thinking, well, that's, you know, makes it easier. Not really. Early on, yes. Having an extra character makes a big difference and things are falling off my desk. Just like bills. Yeah, bills are great. Yeah, early on, having an extra character, big help. But later in the game, having, you know, splitting the experience one more way, it could actually be a bad thing. That's why I've only increased it by 1. Otherwise, I'd go, you know, probably the full 8 and just make 8 people. Even said, I'd probably end up recruiting a couple of people. But that's besides the point. New game. Normal, not Iron Man, because the save games in this game tend to corrupt very easily. I'm playing lawful neutral. Notice that these are all lit. That means I can only have characters of those alignments in my party. Not like any of this really matters too much. If I was evil, yeah, sure, why not? Because, you know, I would murder everybody and eat babies. If I was extremely evil. I'm not going to be, though. And I just punched my keyboard. It's one of those days. Again, this does make sense. You know, lawful good is someone who, you know, volunteers at a soup kitchen, does really good things, and upholds the law to the letter. That's the kind of lawful good, kind of like a paladin, which I'll be using in this game. Normally, I ignore them like the plague, just because they're too restrictive, but they have too many powers, and it's besides, I'm still using one. Let's just go. I have already made my party, because, well, let me show you. This will take a while. Now, sitting here, you know, I could just roll this and be like, oh, alright, I'll just throw this over here, nah, like that. The thing is, you know, this being a video game and not the actual Dungeons & Dragons game with, you know, role-playing, it all comes down to the numbers. So, end up doing this a lot. And going by, that's actually reasonable stats. Let's just make a fighter, let's say, just for giggles. Just a normal fighter. Why not? Race! Let's just say human for giggles. Gender is... Do they have an innie or an outie? Let's just say he's male. And he's a little bit stumpy. Oh, wow, I just made a joke because my actual fighter is stumpy. With this character, I'm not going to be using hair. Who cares? You're going to be wearing a helmet eventually. Class. Fighter. Why not? Doesn't matter. None. Deity only really matters if you cast divine spells. Other than that, who cares? Class bonus feat, you can tell just from the gold coloring that's pretty much what it is. I didn't make a spellcaster, that'd be a little bit more involved, but eh. Let's get power attack. Just for giggles, I guess. Weapon focus. Again, not using this character. Longsword, why not? And, Proven initiative is pretty nice, actually. Skills! Feats, the thing I just came off, feats are usually something fantastic. If I go down, let's go up. You know, craft magic arms and armor, meaning making a magical battle axe to ruin someone's day. You know, the feats tend to be something fantastic. Not always. Sometimes not so much. Die hard, what the heck? Oh. Skills tend to be something a little bit more mundane. You know, intimidate. Scare the crap out of someone. Listen! This is the kind of thing. There are exceptions like use magical device. Appraise is pretty benign. These aren't, you know, earth-shattering things. Like this gruff person?
Yes, sir.
And, you know, go through that. Let's just skip that. Most of my characters are human, except for my fighter is a dwarf, just because Stumpy isn't his real name. That's his nickname. His real name cannot be pronounced by the human tongue. Sorry. But I have Lily, the paladin. She is mostly my talk-to person, the person who talks to other people because she has good people skills. That's basically her job. Stumpy, my fighter, who he's a dwarf, mostly, you know, because I am playing a fantasy game, and if I made an entirely human party, I think I'd have a breakdown. You know, I've said many, many times, why play a fantasy game if you're going to play humans? But, you know, in Dungeons & Dragons, there's actually an advantage to being human. Being human gives you an extra feat and skill points, which is pretty handy. And this being what it is, you know, I mean, other races such as a dwarf gets extra constitution points, which equals more HP, which is nice. And they lose out on something else. And then there's all kinds of stuff that it's involved. But humans get, you know, extra feats. And I'm just going to go that way. Why not? I suppose I could have made my, druid an elf or a half-elf, because it does make more sense as far as I'm concerned. But that's fine. Try not to puke in my soup at the moment. Calm down there, stomach. Anyway, Harjani, Luke, Lily, Stumpy, you've met them. Ulk was a wizard, and Avil, not there is no R, was my sorceress. Button didn't work. This is something added with the Circle of Eight mod pack, the extra content. Yeah, you can pause this and read this if you wish. Basically, there's a whole bunch of rooms that allow me to spend time to pretty much equip my characters as well as possible. And Lily has blue hair, yes. But I'm just going to go with the default starting equipment because I'm not going to spend a whole bunch of time going through this or skipping it. I'm just going to go start the game.
10 years ago, in the year 569, the dark forces of the Temple of Elemental Evil rose up to face the united armies of Valuna and Furyondi. At Emrydi Meadows, the tide of evil was opposed by the forces of good. The northern armies fought bravely under the direction of the valiant Prince Thrommel. But the forces of evil seemed too great. When at last it seemed that evil would triumph, that the demoness Zugtmoy would destroy the armies of good, a new hope arrived. The Circle of Eight. Zugtmoy was trapped in the dungeons beneath the Temple of Elemental Evil. Left inside the temple dungeons, she gathers her strength and secretly plans a return to power for vengeance. You are summoned before the directing oligarchy of Greyhawk, where the Lord Mayor has requested your presence.
That little slideshow was pretty much the intro movie, which makes the game crash with the mod pack installed, just in case you're wondering. Pretty much sums up the intro movie. I'm probably said part of that once, twice. Once? Twice? Well, of course you said it once. It's one of those days. But anyway, little thing that my druid fortunately has, she can summon an animal companion, and I'm going to have a jackal, who is going to be named Snugglecakes, or Mayro, whichever. Oh god, that LP still going on. The cursed one. Hopefully this isn't another one of those. Also, so you know, familiar. I'm just gonna summon some toads because
whatever
it gives them a little bit more HP. Where was I? What was I talking about? What was important
Very
enough
well.
To actually speak about? Yeah, apparently the whole Circle of Eight thing, don't think that little slideshow that was some conceit on the developers of the mod pack. I haven't played the Temple of Elemental Evil module myself, but apparently, you know, the Circle of Eight was a major plot point, and this game originally kind of just skimmed over it and ignored it, except for the intro movie, but doesn't actually mention who they are. Oops. Anyway, let's start the game instead of blithering on like an idiot.
You have been summoned to the Council Chambers to perform an important mission for Grail.
Really?
Our friends to the west in Verberbonk have requested our help with a growing chaos near the town of Homlet. Bandits ride those roads again, and the village folk grow concerned for their safety.
Bandits to justice and all that. Lawful neutral. It's always the law.
Excellent. We have the utmost confidence in you.
To my paladin, who is lawful good, but then again, lawful good and neutral, lawful neutral get along, so it's fine.
Please travel at once to Homlet and seek out Kenter Nevitz, the village elder.
You will not be disappointed.
As directed by the Lord Mayor of Greyhawk, you arrive in Homlet to find the village elder Kenter Nevitz and learn the source of the local bandit raids.
And I'm pretty sure what this is... you know, word for word intro from the module. That's my guess. Again, no idea. Maybe somebody watching this knows. I don't. So, you know, read it if you wish. Well, let's start the game. Finally. It's only been 14 minutes. Let's see. What else do I need to do? Nothing too much. Unfortunately for me, all of my characters are level 1. Level 1 characters are good at two things, mostly. The first one is dying repeatedly, a lot, almost pretty much like XCOM soldiers. Yeah, kind of think of that. They're very good. Even, you know, not, even ones that have very, very good stats, like,
okay.
Lily here has, her lowest score is 12, and that's still above average. Yeah, there's that. People with, you know, more normal scores, not super scores like I'm using, again, well, this game's not really forgiving either. Yeah, normal score characters die a dime a dozen. If, you know, whoever is running the game in the pencil and paper version isn't it, yeah, they die horribly if they're mean. And most of my games, yeah, that happen. Anyway, let's move on.
Wow, are you some sort of adventurer?
Yes.
Are you here to find treasure? Oh, you must be here to kill monsters. Tell me.
You know, maybe it's because of my alignment, or the extra content, but I never remember ever encountering this boy before doing this.
I can try. I know a lot for my age. Ask me, you'll see. I'm smart.
Right. Do you know where Kenter Nevitz lives?
I never met him. I hope I do. You should ask the Badgers. The Badgers are the greatest. I want to join them when I grow up. Maybe you can work for them.
You're no help to me. I'll be leaving now.
Okay, see ya. I gotta get back to my yard.
Yes, you do that. Make sure it doesn't move. Yeah? Yeah, that boy. Another thing you're going to discover. Character pathing is pretty terrible. Especially Ulk here. For some reason, whoever is standing in, like, that kind of position, they just fail miserably constantly. There is going to be some juddering, but, you know, the game doesn't crash. Also, another thing, if you've played the original and haven't played the mod pack, playing the original, being, you know, obviously the map of the town, normally, there would be a fog of war. If you've ever played Warcraft, you know exactly what that is. You know, Warcraft 2, 3, whatever. Usually, you start right here, you can see about that much, and everything else is black. Favorite change so far is that one right there. Being able to tell where I'm going without having to explore the entirety of the town first. There are a lot of things to do. There is, with the mod pack, there is, some combat-related questing that I could do to try to get myself up to level 2. There is also the original game's, basically, you know, boring quest of boringness. That should push you to level 2. I'm gonna do both of these, just because, well, experience is nice. And I would really like to get up to level 2 and 3, especially 3.
Hello there, pretty lady.
Yes.
No, I'm not drunk. I'm Elmo.
How nice for you.
I'm looking for work. I need the money, you see. I would like to buy some ale. I'm an armed man. No, I mean a man at arms. I can work for you, but I need to get some chainmail and a big axe. And I will work for only half of the share of the money.
This man is one of the NPCs that you can recruit during this game. To be fair, as far as the vanilla version of this game goes, Elmo here is probably one of the better ones. Simply because he only takes money, he doesn't take items. However, you will be subjugated to his, shall we say, very unique walking patterns.
Yeah, you give me 200 gold, and then I join you.
Yes, he,
and
he's...
And you only have to pay me half money share from then on.
Yes, so I can hire him in the original... And he will stagger around everywhere.
You change your mind about old Elmo?
This is a little bit strange. The fact that they added this, I don't know, maybe somebody got really annoyed at the fact that he staggers. You can actually sober up Elmo. I might be back.
Then. Maybe later.
I might be back for Elmo later. He is a fourth level fighter. He's actually pretty damn good. I think he multi-classes into some... I'm sure, you know, anybody who doesn't play... has never played Dungeons & Dragons, I'm throwing out words that you have no idea about. He eventually takes levels in another class other than fighter, which is what Stumpy is. So, you know, I'm not sure if I'm actually going to use Elmo. I do have one deficit in my party that I definitely need to take care of, though. But that's not right now. The next thing I want to do is talk to this man, the blacksmith of the town. Mostly because I need armor and shields. Can I look at your trade goods, sir? Oh, some chainmail. It's much better than brown leather armor. Let's get some armor for you. And I think, yeah, my cleric has, you know, a terrible dex score. Well, he has a normal dex score, but it was like, oh, I got an 18 and two 17s. I'm not throwing this away. That would be stupid. Give you that. Give my druid one of these. There is no free hand. If I go to that, throw this away, get rid of that. And druids mostly can only use wooden or natural materials, like, you know, hide armor or something like that. But they are allowed to use scimitars for some reason. Never understood why. Maybe it's because it might look like a fang or a claw. That's the only thing I can guess. I don't know the reasoning behind it, but whatever. Don't care. So you have that. AC 16, 14, 16, 17. That's actually a nice mix. Since, you know, these first four people are going to be engaged in melee. No physical combat. There is one more thing I can talk to Brother Smith about. Are you a masterwork quality artisan? This is important. In the original game, the masterwork is actually really important. This is mostly for later. A lot of later. I'm not cut out for that? Really? Who'd do just as well with the toy items? The Fisher Price adventuring gear. Perhaps you should reconsider certain that. You know, one of these days, I will be able to talk. Boy. This guy wants me to bring the head of a giant. If I try to fight a giant right now, I will be a small red stain somewhere. Mostly on the end of its club. Level 1 character versus a giant? Haha, no. I don't care how many of us there are. We would need at least, like, 60. not that many, but quite a few. The whole masterwork thing. This wasn't the original game. It was added later. Getting masterwork items is actually really important because to make a magical item, to maybe enchant an item, the item has to start out as a masterwork. All magical items, except for with some exceptions, were masterworks. This guy pretty much allows me to make will allow me to make various magical items, which will definitely improve my survivability, especially when I start making, you know, especially with, you know, magic armor, not to mention magic weapons, which is fantastic. But anyway, there is just so much more to talk about, so much more to do. I mean, I could rant on about another 20 minutes just sitting right here, but I won't. Next time, probably do, you know, a couple of running around quests in the town. If I was a different alignment, some of them, you know, you murder a couple of dudes and then you come here. But, nope, not ours. We're probably not going to fight anything for a while, which isn't too exciting, but it's better than a game over screen. So anyway, until next time.